For today's video, we'll be taking a look at a higher-end motherboard from MSI that sports the new mid-range AMD B850 chipset and is targeted at you folks out there who are intending to build a white-colored AMD AM5 PC, the MSI MPG B850 Edge TI WiFi. Sporting support for the latest Ryzen 9000 series of processors, as well as the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs and the older Ryzen 7000 series of CPUs, we'll be taking a closer look at the specs of this board to see if it's any good. Let's get started. To recap, AMD launched its Zen 5 Ryzen 9000 series of processors back in August 2024, and the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets for the AM5 platform back in September 2024. Fast forward to January 2025, we now finally have AMD's mid-range and entry-level 800 series chipsets arriving on the scene, in the form of the B850 and the B840. To get in on the launch excitement, we'll be taking a look at the MSI MPG B850 Edge TI Wi-Fi that, as its name implies, sports the B850 chipset and sits within the MPG series of performance-oriented motherboard offerings at the higher end, where it places below MSI's flagship MEG series and above the MAG series that is targeted at the mainstream demographic. As can be seen, the MPG B850 Edge TI Wi-Fi comes in a rather colorful box with an image of the motherboard splashed across the front. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALKtech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. With that, let's have a look at the contents of the box. First up, we get a white-colored Wi-Fi antenna in this box right here. Let's set aside the board for now to see what else MSI has included with it. We've got a whole bunch of cables here, starting first with a single SATA 3 cable. And this is accompanied by an EZ front panel cable that helps make hooking up the front panel connectors of your PC case to the motherboard a breeze. We do also get an addressable RGB extension cable right here. And this is accompanied by a special 1-to-3 EZCon cable, a new MSI-specific feature that allows end users to connect an addressable RGB device, a fan, and a USB device to the EZCon header on the motherboard so as to simplify things. I'll cover EZCon in more detail later on in this video. Now we do also get 3 EZ M.2 Clip-2 attachments, as well as an EZ M.2 Clip-2 remover tool. In terms of documentation, we get a quick installation guide right here, a regulatory information leaflet, as well as a sheet of MSI stickers. Onto the board itself, we see that MSI has gone for a silver and white color scheme, with a white PCB, silver-colored heatsinks, and black hardware connectors. As can be seen, the board comes with an integrated I/O shield design, which is to be expected for a more premium motherboard offering. The rear of the motherboard is quite a standard affair, though we do get some markings that serve as a warning not to install unneeded motherboard standoffs within your PC case, which could otherwise damage the board. MSI has also taken the liberty to include protective paint around the motherboard's screw holes so as to protect the PCB against scratches, which is a nice touch. RGB junkies will be pleased to note that the board comes with built-in Mystic Light RGB LEDs that can be found on the cover of the integrated I/O shield like so. The VRM heatsinks for this board are decently sized, and MSI has included 14+2+1 power stages with 80 amp power phases. The B850 chipset has a single chip design, and the SID chip sits beneath this large passive heatsink right here. For M.2 drive cooling, MSI has provided full heatsink coverage for all four M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the MPG B850H Ti Wi-Fi comes with four DDR5 slots with a dual tap design that, as of the time of publishing this video, comes with support for up to 256GB of RAM and the DDR5 8400 standard when overclocked. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, along the long edge of the board is a USB 20Gbps Type-C front panel header, and further down, two USB 5Gbps Type-A front panel headers, with each header providing support for up to two USB 5Gbps Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. We do also get two USB 2.0 front panel headers along the bottom edge of the board, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports, for a total of four ports. Some interesting features to highlight. Back at the top of the motherboard, we get a set of EZ debug LEDs and an EZ digi debug LED that can help with troubleshooting PC startup issues. We also get an EZCon header right here. As mentioned earlier, EZCon is a new MSI-specific connector, and it allows end users to easily connect MSI's next-generation AIO CPU coolers to the motherboard with just one onboard connector. For end users who do not have such a MSI AIO cooler, the EZCon header can still be used with non-MSI devices via the included 1-2-3 EZCon cable included with the motherboard, which, as can be seen, comes with an addressable RGB header, a 4-pin fan header, as well as a USB header. Moving on, near the primary PCIe 5.0x4 M.2 slot is a TPM header for an optional TPM module. And near the bottom edge of the board, we get a chassis intrusion header. We do also get an 8-pin supplemental PCIe power connector that provides for an additional source of juice for the power-hungry flagship GPUs of tomorrow. According to MSI, the said connector can provide up to 252 watts of supplemental power. Moving on, we do also get a clear CMOS header as well as a safe boot jumper right here that, when enabled, forces the system to boot with default BIOS settings and a lower PCIe link speed from the CPU. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card. The said slot sports MSI's Steel Armor 2 design so as to reinforce the slot for use with heavy graphics cards. As can be seen, the slot also comes with the EZ PCIe Release feature that helps make removing a graphics card a painless affair. Pressing down on this button here will undo the latch for the installation or removal of a graphics card, and we even get a little window that shows whether the latch is locked in place or not. Pretty nifty. Rounding off this section on expansion slots, we do also get a full-length PCIe 3.0 X16 slot that operates at X1 mode, as well as a full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode. Do note that the full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode shares bandwidth with the third M.2 slot, where the said slot will operate at X2 mode when you've got a M.2 drive installed in slot M.2_3. Also, in case you're unaware, PCIe 5.0 is only supported when you have a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. It's worth noting that the Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. If you do have a Ryzen 8000 APU installed on this board, depending on which model of APU that you have, the primary PCIe 5.0 X16 slot for a graphics card will operate at either PCIe 4.0 X8 mode or X4 mode instead. In the storage department, MSI has included four SATA 3 ports, with all ports in a right-angled configuration so as to aid with cable management. For M.2 slots, it comes with two PCIe 5.0x4 M.2 slots, a PCIe 4.0x2 M.2 slot, as well as a PCIe 4.0 X4 M.2 slot. Do note that all of these slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives will not work in any of these slots. The primary M.2 heatsink features a toolless design called EZ M.2 Shield Frozer 2, which makes removing and installing the heatsink really easy. All you've got to do is press down on the button located at the side of the heatsink and lift the heatsink away from the board. Reinstalling it is a cinch too, simply slide it back into place and press down till you hear a click. Another quality of life feature that the M.2 slots have is EZ M.2 Clip 2, which is a spring-loaded standoff device that makes installing and removing a M.2 drive a toolless affair like so. As can be seen, the EZ M.2 Clip 2 device is pre-installed only for the primary PCIe 5.0 X4 M.2 slot. If you'd like to install the EZ M.2 Clip 2 for the other slots, you can use the included EZ M.2 Clip 2 Remover tool that comes in handy to install and remove the EZ M.2 Clip 2 device accordingly. As mentioned earlier, do note that when you've got an M.2 drive installed in the third M.2 slot, which operates at PCIe 4.0 X2 link speeds, the full-length PCIe 4.0 X16 slot that operates at X4 mode will drop down to run at X2 link speeds instead. Again, do bear in mind that PCIe 5.0 is only supported with a Ryzen 9000 series or Ryzen 7000 series processor installed. The Ryzen 8000 series of APUs only support the PCIe 4.0 standard. For audio, MSI has included a high-end Realtek ALC4080 audio codec, while for wired internet connectivity, we get a Realtek RTL8126 chip that provides support for 5 Gigabit Ethernet. Wi-Fi support is courtesy of a Qualcomm QC-NCM865 Wi-Fi 7 part that supports the 320MHz channel width and also serves up Bluetooth 5.4 support. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with a whopping 8 fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are 3 Gen 2 addressable RGB headers and a single 12V RGB header located in these regions. Moving over to the rear I/O, the MPG B850HTI Wi-Fi goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with a flash BIOS button that allows you to update the board's BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card, a clear CMOS button, a HDMI 2.1 port that supports a maximum output resolution of 8K at 60Hz, 2 USB 10Gbps Type-A ports, 3 USB 10Gbps Type-C ports, a single USB 5Gbps Type-A port, 4 USB 2.0 Type-A ports, a 5 Gigabit Ethernet port, Wi-Fi antenna connectors with the new MSI EZ antenna connectors, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the MSI MPG B850HTI Wi-Fi is a premium motherboard offering targeted at PC hardware enthusiasts who are looking to build a higher-end AMD AM5 PC in white, and it definitely looks and feels the part. The board sports a VRM setup that should handle high-end Ryzen 9000 series processors with ease, PCIe 5.0 support for both a graphics card and 2 M.2 drives, 5 Gigabit Ethernet with built-in Wi-Fi 7, a nice array of USB Type-C and Type-A connectivity options, along with a whole bunch of quality of life features such as EZ PCIe Release, EZ M.2 Clip 2, and so on. Given the specs of this board, I'd say that it definitely gives AM5 motherboards with the high-end X870E and X870 chipsets a serious run for their money, where with the B850 chipset, at least we don't get any PCIe lane bifurcation shenanigans that wind up affecting your PCIe 5.0 X16 slot's bandwidth, as seen with X870E and X870 motherboards in general. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.